But first, let's take a look at what the mainstream media has decided to miss. Well, the fallout over the video of U.S. Marines urinating on dead Taliban fighters continues. The four Marines in the video have now been identified, and reports are saying that they could face charges of war crimes. Now, not because they care about the war in Afghanistan, but because they love scandal, the mainstream media is sticking to the story.
More on that disturbing and disgusting video that we talked about yesterday, showing our U.S. Marines urinating on Taliban bodies.
It's not just about the incident, it's about America and the impact on America's image.
Leon Panetta once again condemning the actions of a handful of Remains seen on tape urinating, being urinated on by Marines of dead Taliban fighters, multiple investigations being launched as the Pentagon tries to really control the damage.
Defense Secretary Leon Panetta has come forward and said the video deeply troubles him. He's ordered a full investigation.
There is deep-seated concern here that anytime something like this crops up, that enemy forces could use it to rally their forces, even as a recruiting tool.
Now, there's been a lot of commentary out there since this video came out. But there's one person that really takes the cake when it comes to showing how sick and twisted and wrong-headed people can be in the face of stories like these. So let me just play a little clip for all of you from the radio of Dana Loesch.
Can someone explain to me if there's supposed to be a scandal that someone pees on the corpse of a Taliban fighter? Someone who was is part of an organization murdered over 3,000 Americans? I'd drop trial and do it too. That's me though. I want a million cool points for these guys. Is that harsh to say? Come on, people. This is a war. What do you think this is?
She dropped trow and do it too, and she thinks that these Marines deserve a million cool points. Now, I have quite a few thoughts on this, but let me just start out by saying that Dana, which she later says in the video, she says she thinks she's being politically incorrect by saying it. Really? You think that you're being politically incorrect? Everyone else is just too sensitive to spew the same kind of filth as you? Let me tell you something. It's not being politically incorrect. It is, I think, morally deplorable, but even more so, it's a sure sign of how uneducated and misguided people are about this war in Afghanistan. It's politically ignorant, is what I'd call it. You see, people like Dana Loesch say that this is war. Get over it. Now, I made a comment yesterday saying something similar in the sense that, yes, this is war, and horrible things happen every single day. Every single day when you're at war. And that's why the mainstream media deserves critique, because they only remember that we're at war when we see an incident like this. But the point is not to get over it and just move on. The point is that we have to ask why we're at war to begin with. Why thousands of soldiers have been dying over the last 10 years in Iraq and Afghanistan, and countless others have been getting injured, maimed, returning with PTSD and horrible psychological traumas. Dana thinks that the troops are fighting to keep us safe. Safe from who? The war in Iraq was based on lies and had nothing to do with keeping America safe. The war in Afghanistan was originally launched in retaliation to go get Osama bin Laden. But Afghanistan hasn't been about Osama bin Laden for a very long time. And that's why we saw the military, the foreign policy establishment, scramble to change the supposed goals a million times over. It's gone from bin Laden and stopping Afghanistan from being a safe haven to Al-Qaeda, to fighting for women's rights, democracy, winning hearts and minds, and building up Afghanistan's own security forces. Meanwhile, completely shielding our eyes to the fact that the government that the U.S. props up in Afghanistan is corrupt, it's full of just as many crooks and killers as those that we speak out against. The warlords that we pay off for safe passage through Afghanistan aren't helping keep America troops keep America safe. Give me a break. So, what I think is the people that Dana should really be taking an issue with aren't those that have attacked her for her statements about supporting the Marines that urinate on dead Taliban. She should take issue with those that sent the Marines there in the first place, the people that are keeping them there beyond any sound logic. We all should. But here's the kicker, too. See, after the mass outrage that was expressed towards Loesch, she decided to write a response. And you want to know what her argument or her defense was? She claims that liberals are just angered with what she said because they don't like the military. Way to divert to an argument that makes absolutely no sense. Liberals go crazy when we see videos of our troops urinating on bodies because we hate the troops so much that it makes us happy to see a scandal. That's BS, and you know it. Liberals, real liberals, of which I'm afraid there are too few out there because they get scared off, they get pushed to the center by people like Loesch and Fox and anyone else on the right wing. Real liberals, they don't like war. They don't agree with the notion the troops are dying on our behalf thousands of miles away and have been doing so for 10 years, and to what end? to cover up the embarrassments and the mistakes of the Pentagon and all the generals that themselves know that it doesn't make any sense. To cover up for the lawmakers that keep funding our wars all in the sake of not looking soft on terror and creating more work for defense contractors that line their pockets and contribute to their campaigns. The military and the troops are not the problem. It's the military-industrial complex. It's the bloodthirsty war hawks that run our government and strike fear into the hearts of Americans on our TV screens to keep those pointless wars going. And so now, let me bring all of this back to CNN. Oh, CNN, the poor, lost, confused, red-headed stepchild of the mainstream media. CNN, as I'm sure most of you know, is losing big time when it comes to their ratings. Losing big time in comparison to MSNBC and especially to Fox. And so in response, they've been desperately throwing whatever they can at the wall to see what sticks and to try and compete. From holograms of Will.i.am, Anderson Cooper spray tanning with Snooki, to people trying to make the people believe that Erin Burnett is just like them, that she's a girl that everyone can relate to. You know, all the while, they like to call themselves the most trusted name in news. They like to pretend that they're different from their other two cable competitors because they're nonpartisan, they're unbiased, they're down the middle and not left or right. And so what do? To try and prove things like that? Well, they pay contributors, hire people like Dana Loesch and Eric Erickson, and think that if they just pit them up against some liberal, it means they're showing both sides of the story and giving everybody a voice. Please, if you think that paying people like Dana Loesch and giving her airtime to spread her vile commentary give you some shred of credibility, I don't know what else to do but laugh. Or maybe cry. I don't know. Overall, I kind of just feel sorry for you. The only thing that would give our mainstream media any credibility in this day and age would be returning to covering actual news. For example, the war in Afghanistan, America's longest war. Or how about being a government watchdog again, questioning those in power rather than regurgitating their every word? Not buying into the partisan political game that keeps all of America distracted and completely ignorant of what's actually going on, of what wars are being fought in their name, and never asking why. Now, you see, all of that, that's what the mainstream media chooses to miss.